right. I'm here in Hotel Divine, Divine or whatever. First rule about Hotel Divine is you do not talk about Hotel Divine. The second rule of Hotel Divine is you check out by midday. I've had better and I've had worse. It's very central. They give you a little praline here and some water, hopefully with gas. Yes, it is. That's good. It's supposed to be over the Danube, but I'm afraid that my side isn't over the Danube, so I'm not going to get much of a ability to film the Danube from here anyway. Oh, what's that? Why can't I close it? Oh, I've got one of these things on it. Oh. Rather irritating. Right. So that curtain goes about that far. That curtain goes about that far. Hang on. There's another curtain here which is supposed to make it dark. Those ones are just for decoration. Okay. Okay. Well, since there's something to put the cases on, I might as well use it. Just in one night bag here. And what is there here? There's a kind of bath for a strangely shaped human being. Thick at one end and thin at the other. Although actually, there is some sense in it, isn't there? Because you could put your fat bottom down there and just have your thin feet down that end. That's not as silly as it looks. And it leaves more room for the door to open. You can have more bath without getting in the way of the door. So it may look strange at first, but there's method in its madness. Right, there's me. Just to prove that it's not me talking afterwards. What have we got? We've got the secret towel language, the Masonic rite of towels. Dear guests, we protect the environment, would appreciate your cooperation. Towel at the ground, exchange please. Towel at the stand, I will use it again, thank you. Uterak, that's the name for a towel. I always thought that meant Tuesday, but I'm completely wrong. Okay. Right. I tried to film it from the outside. Basically, it's dark, obviously. Hi. Ah, you're very fast. Okay, so we just came in the taxi to the centre. Is this the centre square?
This is the Bratislava square, and this is the opera.
Oh, the opera. Okay. So it's very nice. Fantastic. I made some attempts yesterday to film this in the dark, but it wasn't very good. This is Bratislava, and I'm going back to Vienna in order to go on a plane to Poland. So, this is Universitas Komenia Bratislavensis. The law faculty of Bratislava University, hence the Latin. Osobny pristav. That's the Dunai?
Dunai.
Philharmonia. Philharmonia? Ah, nice. And the Hotel Divine, where I was yesterday. overlooking the Danube, but unfortunately at this level it's fenced off. Zamek?
Hrad.
Hrad. Kostel?
Kostel.
Kostel. There's the Danube now.
Yeah.
On that side. Very unique bridge. Brno, Dier and Wien. So it's three separate countries there, Brno being Czech Republic, Dier being Hungary and Wien or Vienna being Austria. So this is basically the same route out of Bratislava to go to three different countries. Nicely illustrated by that notice board. An expo over there. And I have to say that that's not many minutes to get from the centre of a capital city onto an international motorway. That's without that many cars on it either, bearing in mind that it's theoretically rush hour. That's got to add to the quality of life in this place. That having been said, you never know. Brno goes off to the right and Duran Venus carrying on straight. You never know what this would be like though, not on holiday time, because obviously this is the 3rd of August, everybody's at the seaside. Bratislava's not your first tourist destination in Eastern Europe, so as a result it's a nice easy ride out. Whether it's that way the whole year is something that I don't know. Vzdije tak leky vyjet z Bratislavy? He says it's always easy. That's pretty good. So, we now got a fairly normal motorway, and I think I probably don't need to record it much. 189 kilometers to Budapest, 70 to Dier, 62 to Vienna, about 5 kilometers or more, less than that for the airport because it's on this side, the Bratislava side of Vienna. Well, at this point we're coming up to the old border crossing. Bratislava Jarovce. It's a Schengen crossing, so there shouldn't be anybody there stopping traffic and looking at passports. There wasn't coming in, that's for sure. But you've still got to drive slowly though to give them the chance to look at you if they want to. That's a, there was are all customs vans over there. Regardless of the fact of Schengen, there's still customs limits on personal use of cheapest things going from country to country. While waiting for the airplane to go here in Vienna, of course, I couldn't resist buying a Wiener Schnitzel, here with chips and mayonnaise, here in the Brahms and Liszt. Vienna's very own Brahms and Liszt, at which you can just about get Brahms and Liszt if you drink enough of these Zipfer things.